Hello, my darlings, in video land, this is Mr. Willem. One more little vlog for the new year, for the old year. One more vlog before I leave next week for Mythos Con in Phoenix, Arizona. I'm very excited to have found this video of the illustrations for the Dunwich Whore by Santiago Caruso. I think he's a bloody genius. I think this is some of the best, most disturbing artwork that I have ever seen. And one of my chief joys in life, that wretched thing called life, is great artwork that illustrates the fiction and poetry of H.P. Lovecraft. And this young man, I think perhaps I should put on my eyes so I can see better. The better to see you with, my dear. Let's see. Brilliant. Disturbing. Magnificent. I love illustrations of the old houses in Lovecraft's New England. Those haunted houses, and this is magnificent. And this is perhaps my favorite. I actually have this as my desktop. I love haunted woodland, which is one of the reasons I invented Sesquavale. Is this a book? I shall have to find that book. That's a book. Because I must have that artwork in published form. Anyway. You see, I did a Google. What a strange phrase. I did a Google on this morning on the Dunwich Whore. Can't remember why. And I wanted to see what was out there, and I found this video here at YouTube of this magnificent artwork. And what I did not know was that this young man, Santiago Caruso Esquire, illustrates books for Miskatonic River Press. This is one of his delightful illustrations. Another wonderful house. This must be in Dunwich. It's magnificent. And this is for New Tales of the Miskatonic Valley by published by Miskatonic River Press. New Tales of the Miskatonic Valley. By some strange coincidence, you see, I wrote a story earlier this year for a book to be published by Miskatonic River Press called Dead But Dreaming 2. And I wrote them a wee tale. And I think they liked it. And the publisher, Tom, who I shall be seeing next week in Phoenix, Arizona at Mythos Con. Can't wait, it's going to be fabulous. He asked me if I would be interested in writing them a book of fiction, short stories set in Lovecraft's Miskatonic Valley. And I said, okay. and I'm, you know, I don't really order that many mythos books anymore. I'm more into poetry. I'm, at the moment, I'm really obsessed with the poetry of Mallarmé, the French symbolist. However, that's beside the point. So I said certainly, and I'm going to write them a book set in various towns, such as Arkham, Dunwich, Innsmouth. I need to really come up with a good... I've been wanting to write a tale of Innsmouth for a long time. Have not yet found a good idea. But I will. I will. If it kills me. Oh, that would be my lucky day. Mm-hmm. Killed by your fiction. Anyway. I had no idea that this magnificent artist, Santiago Caruso, draws, illustrates their books. The books of Miskatonic River Press. So now, my little... You see, it fills me with a lust to know this. And I begin to plot. The wheels in my twisted, withered brain begin to wheel and whirl. And I plot. How can I convince Tom Lynch of Miskatonic River Press to hire this magnificent artist, Santiago Caruso, to illustrate the book that I'm going to write for Miskatonic River Press. You see how that works? It fills me with... I feel like I'm conniving. It feels almost sinful to plot like this, but I can't help it. Because I want my books to be graced with delicious, decadent, disturbing artwork. So, when I see Tom at MythosCon, I'm going to say, look into my eyes and repeat after me. A book by Willem Pugmire, illustrated by Santiago Caruso. Shall I convince him? Will it happen? Or am I just dreaming my dark dreams? We shall find out. My darlings. Happy New Year!